Okay, so Arul, would you like to start?
Yes, I will start. Okay. Bhuvan can be accessed with bhuvan.nrsc.gov.in. So that is the URL. And when the user is landing to Bhuvan homepage, you will be having five different major sections. So that is the visualization and the free download. That is the first section. The second is the maps and OGC services. Third is the G-Governance dashboard. The fourth is the state portal. The fifth is the download section. So now for this particular mapathon, so most of the data sets are available under the free download section. That is the section number one. So right now you are seeing that under the visualization and free download, you are able to see Bhuvan 2D, Bhuvan 3D, Open Data Archive, climate and environment. When you are going to the Open Data Archive, the interface will have the three different options to select the data. The data can be selected based on the sensor or based on the project or based on the theme. So like that, there are three different options are there. So right now, our interest is to have the data of AVIFS and the List3 and the Cartodem. So these three products, we will be seeing that how it can be downloaded. So by default, it will be selected with the satellite or sensor. When you are going to the select subcategory, you will be able to get the option that the scatterometer data, OceanSat, and the ResourceSat List3, and IMS-1 hyperspectral, OceanSat-1, the ResourceSat-1 and 2 AVIFS data. Now, for that, to start with, we'll go with the List3 data. So when I am selecting this List3 data, the right side map view will be updated with the grid. The grid will be available in the yellow color, the regular shape. That is nothing but availability of the data in Bhuvan. So if the user wants to download the List3 product, they can have four different options. One is the bounding box, another one is the map sheet based download, third is the tile sheet, tiles based download, and fourth is the interactive drawing. For example, if any user wants to have the data of Gujarat region, they can have a freehand drawing like this. And then when the freehand drawing is completed, meaning have to double click to complete the drawing, all the tiles will be highlighted here like this. Suppose if the user is interested to select any particular tile, then they can hold the shift or control button, so they can click whatever the tile is required like this. The tile number based on the geographical reference, they can select and they can have a selection like this. Or if the user wants to download the data based on the open series map topo sheet number, then they can type that OSM number, then accordingly the data will be filtered and it will be visible in the selection window. Now the next one is the bounding box. Suppose if the area of interest is known, what is your lower left, what is the upper right, if it is defined, then the data products will be selected. For example, my minimum longitude is 77, the maximum is 78. The latitude is 22 and the maximum latitude is 23. So like this, I want to download 1 degree by 1 degree tile. When I am selecting this one, my map window will be highlighted with the corresponding selection of the tile and it will be visible like this. Now, once the selection is completed, the user can go for a next. The next, the user will have three different options. One is the metadata, another one is view, another one is download. Now, if you click view, the thumbnail of the quick view of that particular tile will be created and it will be visible here. At the same time, the tile also will be getting highlighted in the app window. If you want to download that one, the user can click the download option and it will be asking for login. For that, the user should have the login with the Bhuvan. So now, how to create the login or how to have the access to the Bhuvan, the login page. Do that one, you have to go the new user section. So when you are clicking this new user section, it will be asking you the username and the email ID. So the email ID might be the working email ID, then the organization. So whatever is given with the asterisk symbol, that is the mandatory field. So we recommend you have the working email ID so that you can get your link. That link can be activated to have the username. So when you are doing that activation, you have to enter your password so that you will have a username and a password. And using that one, one can log into this Bhuvan portal and they can download it. For example, since I have my login, I will directly log in with my username and password, and I will show that how the download can happen. So now I am logging in with my username and password. Once it is the successful login is done, you can see that it will show that welcome username. Whatever the username you have given, that username will be available here. So now when I'm pressing download, it will directly download that particular tile. That tile number is 77 east and 22 north. The corresponding bounding box also will be added. What is the lower left and what is the upper right for that particular tile? What is the size of that tile? Like 2.2 MB, it is showing. All the details will be available here. The people can download it. So in the same way, the user wants to download the AVIF data, that is 56 meter data. The AVIF data can be selected here. And then the same tile mechanism, like whether it can be a bounding box based, or map sheet based, or tile based, or interactive thing. Like I just want to this time select only one particular tile from this coastal region. So now I am selecting that particular tile. So as soon as the tile is selected, it will be highlighted with the red color. Now I am going with the next option. Now here you can see that for that particular tile, you have multiple time frame data. The data sets are ranging from 2009 to 2018. So these data sets can be used as a input for your time series analysis or change detection, what you are trying to do it here. So here you can download this temporal data, and the data can be used for finding out the change detection between 2009 to 2018, and various seasonal data sets are available in this particular selection. The same way, if I want to download the CartoSat 1 based digital elevation model, where one of the problem statement is for creating the drainage map or finding out the low-lying map, the digital elevation model will be very much helpful. For that, you can select CartoSat 1. Under the CartoSat 1, you have a CartoSat version 1, 1.1, 2, 3. So we suggest you to go for a version 3, so which is having the all the improvements done. So what is the improvements done, and what is the intended use, what is the limitation, everything is recorded in the technical document. So the user can select the check the technical document area, and they can download the document, and they can get the details about all the specification about the data sets. They can get it. So now this time what we will do is we will select based on the map sheet number. For that you have to give the open series map sheet number. For example, I am just giving the whatever F43A I am giving. Once it is given, corresponding tile will be reflected here directly in the table of view. So earlier you would have seen that the selection when you are doing through the map, you have to go for next option. But here, since you are typing directly the map sheet number, the corresponding tiles are listed in the table view directly. So now, if I want to view that particular thing, you can click view. Then it will zoom to that particular area, and then the relevant data will be overlaid on the map view, and you will be able to see it. So here you can see that the drainage layer, how it is, or the river stream, how it is flowing. You will be able to get it very nicely in this particular view. So these data sets can be used for a slope map creation, or the drainage map delineation, or finding out the low lying area, all the things. This digital elevation model will be very much useful. So like this, the user can select the different products and they can download it. What all the different products are available? You can see that there is one section called Bhuvan Store. If you click that Bhuvan Store page will be available. Here it will say that what all the different products are available and which year it is updated. What is the extent of each and every product, and what is the expected size? All the things will be there. Almost like we have 60 plus, even the climate and environmental related products are also available, and all those things are tabulated here. And by clicking that product, you can directly land into that particular page. So we suggest you to go through this Bhuvan Store page, so that you will be able to see the different products which is available for free download. So the next section is thematic services. And we will be concentrating here that how the different thematic data sets, whatever is organized in Bhuvan, how it can be consumed in your QGIS software. For that, you can see that whenever you are selecting any particular theme, there will be one option called web services. Once you are clicking the web services option, you will be getting a two further options. One is a WMS link, another one is the web map tile service, that is the WMTS link. So now, for example, what I will show you is, now if anybody wants to find out the hotspot between the 2005-06 and 2015-16, now for that, what is the requirement is, you can select 2005-06 50K land use land cover data, 50,000 scale land use land cover data. So I want to do it for the Karnataka state. So Karnataka state can be selected. If the user is interested to visualize the data, the user can visualize the data like this. Or if they want to see the statistics button can be clicked and it will show the state-wise statistics. If the user is interested to have a district-wise statistics, they can select the district. Accordingly, the district-wise statistics will be generated with the pie chart and all the things will be there. Here you would have noticed that there is an option called web services. Once you are clicking this web service, will be able to see the web map tile service URL and the web map service URL. So now this URL can be taken and it can be connected from the QGIS. So for that, two important parameter one should know it. One is the what is the URL and what is the layer name. Then when these two things are there, by default in our server side, we have kept the coordinate system as EPSG 4326 or the geographic coordinate system, we have kept it. So that the data will be streamed in that particular coordinate system to the user. This is the way one can get the web services from Bhuvan. So what are all the different data sets are available here? Land use land cover 50,000, 2005-06, 11-12, and 15-16. So three season data sets are available in the 50,000 scale. Then the same way when the user is coming for the land degradation, because one of the thing land degradation maps creation also, the data sets are also available readily in Bhuvan. So whatever the map you are creating, you can get the validation from here also. Here you can see that land degradation 2005-06 and the land degradation 2015-16, two time frame data sets are available here. And here one point we would like to make it very clear is the data sets which is the 250,000 scale and above, that data products are available for download. Like the 250,000 scale and above is the land use land cover, the seasonal maps what we have provided here. Here you are the regional map what we have provided here. So you can see that land use land cover map 250,000 scale. Here the user can select 2005-06 to 2018-19, any time frame data they can select it. For example, I want to download 2010-11 data. So here the seasonal data sets are available, Kharif wise map, Rabi wise map and the annual map. All three options are there. I just want to take the annual map for download. Now this time what the user has to do is, here you can see that there is the option called get data. You have to select the get data, and that time what you have to do, you have to log in with Bhuvan. Now you can see that already I have logged into Bhuvan. So when I am pressing login, it is a signing in, because it is the single sign on is enabled here. So when you are clicking this get data, it will ask you to submit the request. Like for doing this hotspot analysis, if someone wants to do the change reduction with this land use land cover from 2005-06 to 2018-19 with the 250,000 scale, what you can do is you can define your area of interest and you can select all the year. Like I want to do for all the year or I want to do for only a few selected years. You can select it using the control button or you can shift, you can hold it and you can drag all the year so that all the year will be selected. Now, this time, what we are doing? We are doing this operation for the research studies. Then the selection can be administrative unit based, like a state or district. Then it can be a bounding box based, whatever the area we want to do it, or it can be a AOI based. Like for example, I just want to do the administrative wise. So like I want to do the change reduction for the entire Orissa state. So once I selected the Orissa, then when you are submitting this particular request, what will happen? Immediately the request ID will be generated and one MOU form will be generated. So this MOU form can be filled and the HOD of your organization can be filled, signed this particular thing. And the once this MOU is received to Bhuvan, we will be giving you a FTP link for downloading the data. So this is the way the land use land cover 250,000 scale data can be downloaded from Bhuvan for this particular mapathon activity. So now To summarize in a simple way, we have two major sites. One is the NRSC Open EO Data Archive, and that is available and that is accessible from by clicking this Open Data Archive section. When you are going here, you will be able to download AVIFS, List3, Cartodem. Like that, you will be able to download all almost like 60 plus products. All those products can be accessible. The list of products can be accessible from one store, the respective pages. And the next section is Bhuvan Thematic Services. From the Bhuvan Thematic Services, almost like 12 different themes are there. Those theme data sets can be accessed as a Open Geospatial Consortium compliance web services, like a web map service and a web map tile service. And that URL and the layer name is already listed under the web services section. And you, by copying that URL and by defining the layer name, you will be able to access in the QGIS or any other commercial software. So that way, the layer can be accessed to from thematic services. Thematic service is also having one download section. The download is only applicable to the data which is more than 250,000 scale or coarser than 250,000 scale. So that is nothing but LULC 250K is available, and it is available as the annual data and the seasonal data, and the data can be downloaded based on the administrative unit or freehand drawing AOI or the bounding box. And based on that selection, the ID, the MOU ID will be generated. So you have to fill the MOU with that particular ID. You have to mail it the respective address, whatever has been given. So then the approval will be happening and the data download will happen through the Bhuvan FTP. The automated mail will be sent to the user. So this is the workflow what has to be followed for downloading LULC 250K data from Bhuvan. Thank you.